We will visit Mexico, as you can see on the screen, to see amusement park, airports, and zoo. So for today, your pilot is Stuti, co-pilot is Spandana, and crew member is Indrani. Over to you, Stuti.
Good evening, everyone. I hope you are all doing well. So today we'll be visiting Mexico, which is officially known as the United Mexican States. Mexico is a fascinating country in the southern portion of the North America. It is bordered to the United States to the south and the west. To the south and the west by the Pacific Ocean, to the southeast by the Guatemala, Belize, and the Caribbean Sea, and to the east by the Gulf of Mexico. It is one of the largest independent nations in the world, with a population of about 111 million. It is one of the most popular tourist countries on the planet. Tourism in Mexico is a very large industry. And Mexico is number one destination for foreign tourists in Latin America region and number two destination in the Americas. The climate varies dramatically across Mexico's vast landscape. This is the flag of the United Mexican States. The flag of Mexico is a vertical tricolor of green, white, and red, with the national coat of arms charged in the center of the white strip. Red, white, and green are the colors of the National Army in Mexico. The central emblem is the Mexican coat of arms, based on the Aztec symbol of the Tenochtitlan, now the Mexican city, the center of the Aztec Empire. Now we'll learn about some of the best amusement parks of the Mexico. The first one is the Six Flags Mexico City Parker and Lennox. It is a theme park located in Tlalpan Forest and Borough on the southern edge of Mexico City. It is owned and operated by Six Flags and is the most visited theme park in Latin America, with 2.8 million annual visitors. The amusement park has many fascinating rides and is open from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. The next one is the Xcaret Riviera Maya. It is a privately owned and operated theme park resort and self-described ecotourism development located in the Riviera Maya. Probably Mexico's most famous theme park, Xcaret, has everything: wildlife, zip lining, swimming, food, shows, hiking, shopping, kids game, and a top-of-the-world tower to look out over the entire property. The park has a lot of attractions, including a river with many water rides. The next one is the Xel-Há Cancún. It is a commercial aquatic theme park and ecotourism development located on the Caribbean Sea coast of the state of Quintana Roo, Mexico. The theme park was founded in 1984 and is under the management and marketing of the Mexican-owned Experiencias Xcaret Group. It is an aquatic park with dozens of water activities to keep you cool and entertained all day. The next one is the Parque de los Sueños. It is a water park recreation center with the ocean slides, pools, and the zip lines, plus a restaurant and a swimming bar. The park has two distinct areas, one with large swimming pools, water slides, and games, and one with the access to the ocean. They provide all gear you'll need to your favorite water sport like snorkeling, paddle boarding, surfing, and more. Now we'll be having a video of the amusement park.
Nobody enjoyed?
Yes.
Okay. Now we will proceed to our presentation.
So now let's get started with some international airports of Mexico. The first one is the Cancun International Airport. It is amongst the most famous and the widely used and the busiest airports in Mexico. It is situated in Cancun, Quintana Roo. It handles the largest international passenger traffic in Mexico. It has two parallel runways, which can be used at the same time and is managed by the ASUR. It has flights to more than 20 destinations in Mexico, along with 30 countries in Europe and the USA, and is ranked in the second place in Mexico. The next is the Guadalajara International Airport. It also happens to be the third busiest airport in Mexico. It has been named after the Miguel Hidalgo, the hero who brought Mexico independence from Spanish rule. It is located around 20 kilometers from the city. The next and the main is the Mexico International Airport. The Mexico International Airport is an international airport serving the greater Mexico City. There are more than 30 international and domestic airlines serving the airport. The airport is about 5 kilometers away from the downtown Mexico City. The next is the Monterrey International Airport. This is an international airport, also called the General Mariano Escobedo International Airport. It is located in the Apodaca, Nuevo León. It handles the air traffic for Monterrey region. It has almost 300 flights per day to the domestic destinations and some US destinations. Let's have a look at one of the airports. The first one is the El Axis Eco Parque. This zoo is the perfect place to see Mexican wildlife in its natural setting. Most of the animals in the zoo have been rescued from poaching rings and the illegal animal smuggling chains. The zoo is home to a large number of animals and birds that are native to Mexico, such as the jaguar, parrot, and a whole plethora of monkeys. It is open between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and has a rating of 4.5 stars. The next is the Crococan Zoo, which was initially a crocodile farm. Today, it is a home to a large species of animals. You can get a chance to get close and personal with the spider monkeys freely roaming in the area and even play with the Mexican dogs if you wish to. The zoo has interactive service where you can hold baby crocodiles and snakes for pictures, feed the wild-tailed deer, and interact with beautiful chirpy parrots. The natural beauty of the Crococan Zoo and the fantastic interactive session together makes this place a must-visit zoo in Mexico. It is open between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and has a rating of 4.5 stars. The next. The next one is the Zoomat. This is probably one of the most diverse zoos in Mexico and was founded in 1942. Today, the zoo spans over 450 acres of Mexican land and is home to jaguars, birds, and other animals. The animals are kept in large cages with vegetarian representative of their natural habitat all around them. The timings are 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. and has a rating of 4.6 stars. This zoo also gives a free entry where you can freely go anytime with your family. The next one is the Chapultepec Zoo, located in the Chapultepec Zoo, Mexico City. The zoo houses more than 2,000 animals from 200 different species. However, the display is incomplete without the three giant pandas in the premises, which were donated to the zoo by the Chinese government. The zoo receives more than 5 million visitors every year, which bears testimony to its popularity. It has a timing of 9 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. and a rating of 4.1 with free entry. At last, we'll be having a look at the Crococan Zoo.
Also that bird, macaw bird.
That was a snake. How can that be?
Yeah. You don't love snakes? You don't like them?
They are snakes.
Do you love pandas?
Yeah, they're cuddly and soft.
Yeah, they are very good swimmers, you know.
But pandas have a very good bite and don't get close no matter how many videos you see on YouTube.
Yeah, and they are very shy. They don't live in that those places where people live. And also they are very emotional. Like when they feel sad, they sit alone. And when they're happy, they dance. It's interesting.
Yeah, that isn't true. That's just shown in videos too.
Yeah.
The likes and all. Man, the pandas are endangered, so they can get extinct yeah. quickly. Yeah.
But many conservation programs are running to save them. Okay, so that's all about our today's presentation. Hope you like our presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, okay. What country are we visiting tomorrow?
Morocco.
Which country?
Morocco.
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 Yes, Morocco.
Okay. I never heard of this.
Yeah. Are you excited?
Yes, yeah, ma'am. This is covered in one of the smallest countries in the world, right?
We will get to know more about this country tomorrow. So hope you enjoyed our today's session. So that's all from our side.
Ma'am.
If you want to share anything, you can share with us. Yes?
Ma'am, there are so cute crocodiles.
Yeah.
Baby
crocodiles. And talking birds.
There are no talking birds. Well, except for parrots, they imitate us.
No, talking
there
birds.
There are one parrot. How? Parrots only imitate us. They don't like to talk whatever they want. So they imitate
us. Parrots talk whatever they want.
No. Parrots will imitate us. They don't talk. That would have been...
Okay, that's all about today's session. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye.